Hello, Vital Sign. Today we're going to talk about Sperner's Lemma, an interesting result from combinatorics that concerns colorings of simplices. To understand Sperner's Lemma, we'll need to go over three concepts first: simplices, triangulations, and Sperner colorings. A simplex is a generalization of a triangle to any dimension. For example, a zero simplex is a point, a one simplex is a line segment, a two simplex is a triangle, a three simplex is a tetrahedron, and so on. Now, we can't fully represent the higher dimensional analogs with the 3D space we have to work with, but we can still define them mathematically. Let me show you one way to think about higher dimensional simplices. First, note that a one simplex or line segment also contains points. A two simplex or triangle also contains line segments and points, and a three simplex or tetrahedron contains triangles, line segments, and points. What do all of the simplices in one or higher dimensions contain? Points and line segments, or in other words, vertices and edges. That means that we can draw out the vertices and edges of an n-dimensional simplex and get some graph theoretic representation of it. In fact, a complete graph on n vertices represents the vertices and edges of an n-1 dimensional simplex. For example, the complete graph on three vertices represents the vertices and edges of a two-dimensional simplex, or triangle, and the complete graph on four vertices represents the vertices and edges of a three-dimensional simplex, or tetrahedron. We could represent the vertices of a four-dimensional simplex by a complete graph on five vertices. Now on to triangulations. A triangulation of a shape is pretty much what it sounds like it should be, dividing that shape into triangles. Here you can see a couple triangulations of a triangle. And here are a few triangulations of a square. Triangulations can also extend to higher dimensions. What would a triangulation of a three-dimensional shape look like? Well, here's a triangulation of a cube. Triangulating a 3D shape means splitting the shape into tetrahedrons. Generalizing, a triangulation of an n-dimensional shape means splitting it into various n-dimensional equivalents of a triangle, or n-1 simplices. One requirement of triangulations is that each triangle in the triangulation either shares no vertices, shares one vertex, or shares a common edge with another triangle in the triangulation. Also, keep in mind that we can triangulate a line segment, which is really just a one-dimensional version of a triangle, or a one simplex. Triangulating a line segment means splitting it into smaller line segments. Here are some examples of triangulations of line segments. Just one more concept to go before we get to Sperner's Lemma: Sperner colorings. Say we have a triangulation of a simplex, such as the triangulation of a triangle ABC, like this. Then a Sperner coloring is one in which we give a different color to each original vertex of our triangle, and then color any vertices of our smaller triangles that happen to fall on an edge of our original triangle according to a special rule. A vertex V that falls on the original triangle edge AB must be colored with either the color of vertex A or the color of vertex B. In other words, if one of the vertices of our smaller triangles falls on an edge of our original triangle, it must be colored with one of the colors used on the endpoints of that edge of the original triangle. Now color the smaller triangle's vertices that lie within the original triangle however you'd like. That is all there is to a Sperner coloring. Sperner's lemma in one dimension states that if you take a line segment, color its endpoints with different colors, and then triangulate it, that is, subdivide it into smaller line segments with a vertex at each point of subdivision, and then apply a Sperner coloring to the vertices of that triangulation, then there will be an odd number of line segments in that triangulation with endpoints of different colors. I encourage you to triangulate some line segments yourself and see that this holds. Think about it this way. If we start and end on a different color, then there must have been an odd number of color switches along a line segment. It's the same concept as the fact that if you start with an even number, add one to it some number of times, and end with an odd number, you must have added an odd number of ones. Also, notice that each line segment within our triangulation corresponds to a switch of color. Therefore, if there are an odd number of switches of color, there are an odd number of line segments with endpoints of different colors. That is why the 1D Sperner's lemma is true. This will be super important for our 2D case. The 2D Sperner's lemma states that if you triangulate a triangle and apply a Sperner coloring to the vertices of that triangulation, then there is at least one triangle within your triangulation such that all its vertices are colored with a different color. Let's say we have a triangle ABC where vertex A is colored with color 1, or blue in this case. Vertex B is colored with color 2, or red in this case. And vertex C is colored with color 3, or black in this case. By the way, we're going to continue referring to blue as color 1, red as color 2, and black as color 3 in this video. Then let's suppose we triangulate this triangle and color it according to the rules of a Sperner coloring. Now let's try something interesting. Let's build a graph G on this triangulation with one vertex for each triangle in the triangulation, as well as one vertex for the area around our triangulation, which we'll refer to as the external face. For the purposes of this video, let's call this new graph our face graph, as each vertex in the graph corresponds to a face or a triangle in our triangulation. And let's impose a rule for connecting vertices in this new graph. Two vertices in the face graph are connected if their corresponding faces in the triangulation share a common edge with one endpoint of color 1 and one endpoint of color 2. In the example I've shown, that would be one blue endpoint and one red endpoint. That would mean that vertex T1 connects to T2, T5 to T6, T7 to T8, T1 to T6, and T7 to the external face vertex. We're going to make these connections in a little bit, but right now we're going to leave the face graph empty so that we can fill it in as we consider general properties. Think about the vertex corresponding to the external face of our graph. How many connections will it have? In this case, it's 1, due to this line segment that the exterior face shares with triangle T7. But in all cases, it will be an odd number of connections. This is because there are always an odd number of edges on the boundary of any triangulation of a triangle with one endpoint of color 1 and one endpoint of color 2. And all such edges occur along the original triangle edge with endpoints of color 1 and 2. In this case, that would be along the edge AB of our original triangle. And why are there just an odd number of edges on the boundary with endpoints of both colors 1 and 2? Because of the Sperner coloring rules and the 1D case of Sperner's lemma. Our Sperner coloring rules tell us that any vertices of a triangulation of a triangle that are on an edge of the original triangle would have to be colored with one of the colors used on the endpoints of that edge. Therefore, in this case, the only boundary edges that could contain endpoints of both color 1 and color 2, used in vertices A and B, must be those that are subdivisions of edge AB. That's these edges here. Or generally, the only boundary edges of a triangulation that contain endpoints of some color 1 and some color 2, used on some vertices of the original triangle, U and V, must be subdivisions of that edge UV. And by the 1D case of Sperner's lemma, there must be an odd number of such edges in any triangulation. Considering that the external face's only connections are through boundary edges on the triangulation, then the degree or number of connections of the face graph vertex corresponding to an external face of any triangulation, including the one shown, must be odd. Moving on with our proof of Sperner's lemma, it is a fact that in a finite undirected graph, the number of vertices with odd degree is even. This is known as the handshaking lemma. Yet since the external face vertex of a triangulation of a triangle has an odd degree, there must be at least one additional vertex somewhere else in the graph with odd degree. And whatever that vertex is, it corresponds to some internal face in the triangulation, that is, a triangle in our triangulation, that has an odd number of edges with one endpoint color 1 and one endpoint color 2. Notice that a triangle can only have 0, 1, or 2 edges with one endpoint color 1 and one endpoint color 2, as it is not possible to have all three vertices alternating between two colors such that each edge has endpoints of different colors. Therefore, if no triangle can have all three edges with one endpoint color 1 and one endpoint color 2, and if we know that there is an internal face or triangle with an odd number of edges with one endpoint color 1 and one endpoint color 2, then that internal face must have exactly one edge of one endpoint color 1 and one of color 2, as 1 is the only odd number out of 0, 1, and 2. The triangle corresponding to our odd degree face graph vertex has one edge with one endpoint color 1 and one endpoint color 2. That means that its remaining vertex must be of some unique color. If it was of color 1 or 2, then there would have been an even number of edges with one endpoint color 1 and another color 2. So we are done. We've proven that in any Sperner colored triangulation of a triangle, there is some internal triangle with vertices of unique colors. For fun, here is the complete face graph for our triangulation, highlighting which vertices have odd degree and their corresponding faces in the triangulation. Let's recap how we got here. First, we constructed a face graph for our triangulation with a vertex for the external face and a vertex for each internal face or triangle in our triangulation. Then we proved that the face graph vertex corresponding to the external face in any triangulation has odd degree. And then we proved that since there must be an odd number of odd degree vertices in any finite undirected graph, there must be at least one other face graph vertex with odd degree. Next, we noticed that a triangle can only have 0, 1, or 2 edges with one endpoint color 1 and one endpoint color 2. In other words, the corresponding face graph vertex for a triangle has a degree of 0, 1, or 2. And by the fact that there is at least one odd degree face graph vertex besides the vertex corresponding to the external face, that additional odd degree vertex must have degree 1, meaning that its corresponding triangle in a triangulation has exactly one edge with one endpoint color 1 and one endpoint color 2. Finally, since all of the vertices in a triangulation and thus of our triangle are given some color, the third vertex of this additional odd degree face in a triangulation must have a color that is not color 1 or color 2. And so it is a triangle with three uniquely colored vertices. Those were the 1D and 2D cases of Sperner's lemma. Sperner's lemma has been applied in other areas of math and in economics as well. That's it for this video. In my next video, we'll talk about a really cool construction in graph theory, the Michelski construction. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe, like, share, and comment. Have a great day.